here.
Right. Dre the Music Man back with yet another video. Oh, I think it's fair to say that streaming has changed the way that we consume music. I'm not saying it's all bad. I'm just thinking we gotta adjust a little bit. After all, streaming has caused certain challenges for the modern music listener. And largely what we're trying to do with these videos is to examine those issues. On that note, I want to suggest that you go to our channel and check out our past content and also hit subscribe so you could stay up to date with what we got coming. Specifically today, I wanted to ask the question, are we letting songs grow on us? To put it another way, is playlist culture eliminating the need to listen to songs that we don't love? It's easier than ever to just use that little add to queue or play next button on your favorite streaming service and avoid any unwanted songs. Along with that, you have the option of finding a playlist that fits your mood or your activity and just skipping the tracks you don't like. When I describe it like this, it kind of sounds like a good thing, doesn't it? It is. Largely, it is. Streaming services like this give us the possibility of listening to pretty much anything we want. But I think, without realizing it, we've lost something too. When I was younger, it was all about CDs. And a CD player would play one CD at a time, so out of pure convenience, you'd let these CDs run their course. And through this process, you were able to discover the deep cuts, the non-singles. The single got all of the attention, radio play, music videos, a near guarantee that the artist would play it at a concert. But the deep cuts were another story. It's almost like you had to be a real fan to discover these songs. As a fan, you would carry them around in your back pocket and take pride in showing these to your friends. Later in my life, I discovered vinyl records, but the same sort of thing happens. Inevitably, if you stick to these formats, you start falling in love with songs that you didn't really like on the first listen. Take Stevie Wonder's Songs in the Key of Life, for example. I kept going to the second album side for I Wish, and then I discovered Knocks Me Off My Feet and Summer Soft. And well, Knocks Me Off My Feet became the song we played at our first dance at my wedding, and Stevie Wonder, well, he's a legend in my eyes now, a top 10 artist for me, because I allowed some time for the music to grow on me. Some music requires additional listens for proper appreciation. Now, I want to clarify something here. I'm not suggesting that you can brainwash yourself into liking whatever music you want if you just listen to it enough. That's ridiculous. What I am saying is that there is the possibility that our brains need a little more time to absorb the sounds we're listening to. I'm suggesting that there is a time to skip through until you get to your favorite track. There is a time to keep that favorite track on repeat, but also there is a time to revisit an album that you've only listened to once. There may be more to it than just that catchy single. If it's done right, you could encourage your musical tastes to grow. And the way I see it, the more music you love, the more happiness there is in your life. It's that simple. So I urge you to get curious. If you weren't really feeling it on the first listen, but something's telling you to revisit, don't hesitate. Check the album out. You might be surprised what you find. We want to remind you to hit subscribe. I'm going to be diving into topics like this regularly. I'd love to have you along for the ride. So until I see you next, remember everybody, make some time for music.